Hey, you.
Who are you? State your business.
I am Alistair Sarwick, loyal servant to the Crown. I wish to have an audience with Queen Cersei.
The Queen only receives petitioners when holding court. Why don't you explain how you got into the throne room instead? Guards, seize him!
Lover.
Just a moment, Sir Celtigar. Bring me that man.
My thanks for granting me an audience, Your Grace. I am Alistair Sarwick of Riverspring, bannerman to House Lannister.
Yes, that name conjures something. You're the man who was arrested for murdering the Goldcloaks. What I don't know, on the other hand, is how you managed to barge straight into the heart of the Red Keep. Explain to me, then, how you were able to evade the palace guards.
Your Grace, with all due respect, I cannot answer that.
Really? You're playing a very dangerous game, Sir Alistair. I appreciate persistence, but a sensible man should always know when to submit. I will ask you one more time. How were you able to accomplish that feat?
Means matter little to one such as myself. What truly count are the ends. I could have left this keep without looking back, but I would rather offer my talents to the Crown.
You may rise, sir. You have my full attention.
Nice.
Many thanks, Your Grace.
Despite your goodwill, know that you are taking terrible risks.
Look at that squad. A
lion. If I must take you into my service, I would first be certain of your absolute loyalty. How did a prisoner such as yourself come all the way up from the dungeons?
Your Grace, I left the Red Keep in order to come of my own free will and submit to your wisdom. I place myself in your merciful hands. Know that I was imprisoned here after an unfortunate misunderstanding. However, it is as your humble servant that I wish to leave the Red Keep.
Why do you wish to assist me? What is it you want?
I learned that my sister, Elyana, was promised to Valar. An unfortunate choice, I'm afraid.
How so?
Because he is bastard-born, Your Grace. Not only would it be a poor alliance, but our father's blood runs in his veins. I cannot accept such an improper marriage.
Let me remind you that Sir Valar was knighted by my own father, Lord Tywin Lannister. That alone should convince you of his merit as future Lord of Riverspring. And if I'm not mistaken, your brother Garwin is accused of killing your father, is he not? When your sister came to see me, I saw no other choice. Sir Valar grew up at Riverspring in the heart of the castle itself. He was the one capable of ensuring the protection of these lands, as well as that of your sisters.
With your permission, my lady, I have returned, and as the firstborn son of my house, it is up to me to decide what happens to my family. No doubt my long absence has left me but a distant memory to many here, but I am still my father's lawful heir.
Why do you not submit your grievance to the king when he is holding court? I'm certain that your request will be granted.
Riverspring is under the rule of House Lannister. In any decision regarding its future, the king will defer to you or to your father. I decided to come straight to you in order to avoid wasting time.
Very astute, my lord. But you will understand that, however generous she may be, a queen may not act strictly out of charity. There are important tasks which must be carried out with the utmost discretion and efficiency. Would you be ready to undertake such a task for your queen?
Oh my god.
My loyalty to my queen has never wavered. Tell me what you wish of me and I will not disappoint.
Very well, Sir Alistair. Your request has been heard. Serve me well, and I will make certain that Riverspring is returned to you. Disappoint me, and we will allow the King's justice to follow its course in your regard.
That will not happen.
I am delighted to hear that. We have it from reliable sources that enemies of the Crown are running unchecked in King's Landing, and I want their heads. And since it appears that you and Sir Valar have the same objective, it is my wish that you carry out this mission together. And why not use this opportunity to find out who is more dedicated, you or your half-brother?
Your Grace, I would like to discuss one last matter with you. It concerns my brother, Garwin. I was at Riverspring for my father's burial, and there is, for the moment, no proof that my brother killed our father. I know not who informed the Crown of my brother's guilt, but it would seem that he was judged too quickly. I dare ask one more favor of you. Please withdraw this accusation until there is formal proof of his guilt.
I see. It is an enormous boon that you ask of me. Very well.
Nice.
To prove my faith in your abilities, I will lift the reward on your brother's head.
The
watch will leave him in peace. For the moment.
I praise your Grace's generosity.
For now, go and await me in the antechamber. There are matters I must discuss in private with Sir Valar. We will speak again shortly.
So they restore you.
Doing here? You were supposed to rot in the dungeons.
That is indeed what I feared, but the light of R'hllor guided my steps out.
Sir Valar, the Queen awaits your presence.
We shall meet again, Alistair.
Man, the head of this guy is amazing.
Sooner than you think.
Chapter 5, Morth. Present day. If you want to read, read, because I'm not gonna read for you guys.
Unfortunately, I'm afraid it's true. The royal seal and the missive were still unbroken when the Raven arrived.
That would mean that he passed shortly after I left King's Landing. I will pray to the Seven that his soul receives the welcome it deserves. He was a great man.
In his letter, he mentioned being wary of those around him. He feared for his life and talked about enemies of the realm who were preparing to strike. A troubling coincidence. I'll wager it has something to do with the girl.
Mm-hmm. Who knows? In any case, he must have thought her very important.
Do you still hope to carry out your mission, Sir Donnelly?
Yes. I shall not betray my lord's last wish. I must finish carrying out his orders and find a safe place for the girl. Now that we have an idea of where she is, there is no need to trouble you any longer.
You underestimate the Mole's town tunnels. They're quite a labyrinth for newcomers. You'll need my expertise.
I would also prefer one of us to accompany you. I'd rather know what's going on in the gift.
Very well. I have a host of men waiting south of Castle Black on the way towards Molestown. I hope to meet with them and gather any news before proceeding. Jared, my lieutenant, will have warned my men of our arrival.
I'm counting on you, Mors. Report to me when you've finished your mission.
Shut up.
We'll leave immediately. I just need to make sure of one last thing.
As you wish, sir.
Theomar! Dick! Lion!
Dick.
I shall accompany Sir Donnelly to Molestown. His camp is close by. I am counting on you to get there as soon as possible. You must ensure that peace is maintained in the gift.
Very well, Mors.
Let us ride, sir. It's a long way to Molestown.
I'm right behind you.
Okay, so next time we will do more things like those sub-quests. So see you guys next time.